gonna call our friend Mr. Bolek to get an update on how he's doing. So we will see how that goes. Told him I'd give him a call right at 2. So we will give him a call right now. Come on, telephone. Well, after all the technical difficulties beyond my control, now I've got in touch with TriMark MC, Mr. Bolek. So, I've been trying to do this for 2 days, and hopefully this video will come out. So everybody's been asking about you and everything else, so I thought I'd let you have the reins of the audio and let people know how you're doing and what happened and all that good stuff. So it's all yours, man. Take it away.
All right, Mr. Netherton, or should I say Spurn the Cowboy. As I guess a lot of the people know who've been watching these videos and stuff, I've got 4 broken ribs, broken scapula, which is my shoulder blade, and my left ear sliced up pretty good. Spent about 4 days in the hospital. And while I was in there, I got a collapsed lung also, which they got straightened out in the hospital there. But my ears stitched up good. My ribs are feeling better. My shoulder blade is feeling better. I'm slowly recuperating. I still can't lift my right arm up, you know, at all. And it has no strength. It basically just hurts when I take real deep breaths or move fast or try to lift anything heavy. You know, either with my left or my right, it'll still hurt my ribs there. Mm-hmm. So, doctors say it's going to be probably a couple of months at least. I've got a doctor's appointment tomorrow for the checkup on the ribs and shoulder blade in Nashville. And I'm just going to take some time mainly to recuperate. I know I'll have to go through some physical therapy with my arm and shoulder just because I can't. I can bend my arm at the elbow and use my hand to hold glasses and stuff like that. But like I said, it's pretty weak. And I can't lift it at the shoulder, my arm at the shoulder at all still yet. It's very, very painful. Well, that's about it with the injuries.
Okay, when did they say that you may or may not be able to go back to work? Didn't they say they gave you until like January or something?
Well, yeah, a couple of months. The doctor said it's going to be at least January before my arm is healed up good enough to be doing anything. But my doctor here in Murfreesboro, my normal doctor who has to fill out the paperwork to get the short-term disability thing going, he seems to think it's going to be probably towards the end of February.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, we're talking 2-3 months at the minimum, I think.
Well, we ain't as young as we used to be, so it takes longer to heal.
Yep. Yep, in my mind I'm 25, and in my body I'm 63.
Yeah, I think that's all of us, man. I think that's all of us.
Yep.
So. Okay, a lot of people want to know exactly what happened. So I've got some pictures of the bike that your wife posted on there. So I'll flash some pictures on there while you're talking and everything. So what exactly do you recall? What exactly happened?
I'm not exactly sure what happened, what caused the wreck. I somehow lost control. I don't know if I gave it the gas too fast and spun out, or I don't know. I don't know what caused it, actually. But I spun to the right, went in front of went sideways into a pickup truck, and, it was on the oncoming side, which they were stopped for the light, so the truck wasn't moving. And I slid into it and hit it like kind of on my right side of my three-wheeler at the back part, and then bounced up onto the side, onto the left side of my three-wheeler, up on one side where my right front tire was pointing up. And I don't remember, it happened pretty quick. I don't remember all exactly the details or anything. I just can tell that, I know that's how I hit.
Mm-hmm.
But I still don't know what caused it. I'm thinking it was my own error, I think, because I've been back to the intersection and I don't see any kind of anything on the road. I think it's a combination of maybe just at that intersection where you turn left at that light, it's slightly uphill and it's kind of a sharp turn to the left. And I think it's a combination of that slightly uphill, sharp turn, and me maybe giving it too much gas, maybe into the turn, accelerating more than I thought I was, or, you know, giving it more gas than I thought I was, caused me to start to spin out.
Mm-hmm.
I think.
So you lost traction, yeah.
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know exactly still what caused it.
Well, at least when you went on it. At least when you went on your side and everything, your roll bar and your four-point harness kept you inside the cockpit, so it was just did what it was designed to do.
Yeah. When I built that thing, I built it. You know, anybody that's seen it sees that I sit down inside of a enclosed cockpit area, and then I have that roll bar up behind my head, and that all protects me good. The harness, which I wear all the time, goes around my waist and then over my shoulders. And it kept me in there. I mean, I stayed in the seat, and even when it chipped down the side, I was kind of hanging there. You know, I couldn't get out of it until I unbuckled the belt, and then I kind of dropped out of it.
But, yeah.
It kept me in there.
Well, it was a good thing it didn't flip on top or anything, but that harness was still what kept you in there, so that's a good thing.
That roll bar, I think, would have kept it. Well, I think the roll bar kept it from going all the way upside down and onto me, too, because it was... You know, it did what it was supposed to do. It was leaning on the side, and the roll bar was keeping it from rolling all the way over.
Mm-hmm.
So, it did what it was supposed to do.
Okay, so now you've had time to look at the carnage of everything. So, what do you expect? You're going to be able to rebuild it, like the $6 million man, rebuild it. It'll be better and stuff like that. So
yeah, it'll be better, I think. Yeah, I rebuilding it. It's most of the damage is the framework, the lighter framework that's holding the bodywork and stuff. I have two main frame rails going from the front to the back. Those are 2x2-inch square steel tubing. Those are not damaged at all. And then the cockpit area, that's like 1.5-inch square steel tubing with 1-inch steel bracing. That's not damaged at all. It's not damaged except from the roll bar back.
Mm-hmm.
And but most of it is all but like the hood got torn off, the hood that covers the back area there and stuff. And then the body panels are just riveted on, so they all them rivets came off.
Yeah.
So I'm going to have to redo the whole thing. The roll bar did break and crack when it rolled. And so when I redo this thing, that was a big concern of mine, because the roll bar was actually three pieces that I had welded together and then mounted onto the frame there. But I am going to have a single piece of steel tubing, have it bent to the shape I want, to have it as a one.
Yeah,
I never passed out or anything, and when I unbuckled, after I stopped moving and I was like at my side, I was like above the ground about a foot or so, you know, like kind of sideways, and I unhooked and dropped down, and I could see there was blood dripping from the left side of my head onto the pavement. And I, you know, when I put my left hand up, was holding on my side of my head. Like, I started to stand up, and all these people kind of grabbed me and kind of said, you know, hey, take it easy, lay down. And that's after I was laying there, that's when my ribs and stuff and my arms started hurting real bad.
Mm-hmm.
You know, after the adrenaline, I guess, was wearing off. it was starting, and it was getting kind of difficult to breathe. I could breathe, but I could only take shallow breaths, and it hurt every time I moved.
Mm-hmm.
And
well, that's
the animals got there quick. That is, okay, you know that intersection, Memorial and Haynes, right there.
Mm-hmm.
Well, right there, you know, the sports comms on the corner. Right next to that is a fire station. So there's a fire station, like, just a, you know, I don't know, half a quarter mile from that crash. So that ambulance was there, I know, 5 minutes or less, probably.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it went quick. They got there fast. But, and then they took me to Vanderbilt, because that's just a protocol for if it's any kind of a motorcycle type accident.
Yeah. Yeah, because I think Vanderbilt's the number one trauma center in the mid-state, so that's where mm-hmm. they took you to. Like you said, just out of protocol.
Yeah, we were only a couple of miles from the Murfreesboro Medical Center. I had to go all the way downtown Nashville.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that's like me in my situation, because Vanderbilt's is one of the top burn centers in the mid-state, right. Probably in the state, so they just went ahead and took me via ambulance to Vanderbilt.
Yep, I think it's one of the top ones in the country, I think.
Yeah, probably so. But a lot of subscribers and everything, and of course, you've been seeing my post about you, and they've been praying for you and sending positive vibes your way and everything else, so I'm sure that everybody was just wondering how you were doing. So I thought I'd do a video and let you talk to them, and I know that I'm glad. I'm sure that everybody else is glad that those prayers did work, and you're doing a lot better than what you were a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah, oh yeah, yeah. I appreciate everybody's concern and prayers and stuff, and I believe prayers work, and I think they worked in this case.
Oh yeah, sure, I do too. I most certainly do too.
Yeah, I was surprised at the response and stuff I was getting and all. I was kind of hesitant to even put anything on Facebook or anything about it. But I saw in the neighborhood I live in, they have a Facebook page, Regency Park Facebook page, and I was seeing some things on there that I was killed. So that's why I put an initial Facebook posting about it. And then I am going to work on a video about this whole thing, too, if I get my computer corrected.
Well, what you ought to do is, the rumors of my death have been greatly exaggerated.
Yeah. Well, I put on there, the Facebook thing I put out there, that, you know, it's just, I've been hearing some false reports out there, so I just want to set the record straight, and then I kind of explained what happened.
Oh, yeah.
That was the day after I was in the wreck.
Mm-hmm.
Because I was on the wreck, in that wreck at 11 o'clock on the Sunday. And then Monday is when I actually posted something on Facebook about it.
Yeah. Well, I understand, man. But yeah, I wanted to, people have been asking how you're doing, and I wanted to get the news from the horse's mouth, and so to speak. So I wanted you to do this a little riding telephone interview type thing so we can post it on YouTube and let everybody know how you're doing. And so I'm glad, I'm personally glad you're doing good, because, you know, I don't have many friends that I've, I don't have many friends that I've known for 38 years, so, you know, I like to keep you around for a little while. And
yeah, I'd like to stick around for a little while.
No, that's right. And
not my time yet.
Yeah. So, you know, next year when you get all healed up and get the TriMark 1100H back on the road again, we're going to take a road trip down to Barber Motorcycle Museum and just have a
plan that for a while.
Yeah, so we'll have that and just have a good old time.
Yep. So let me give my stuff a little plug, if you don't mind.
Oh, please go ahead.
Well, I make videos too. Dave knows that. I TriMark MC is my name, but it's also under my name, Mark Bolek, MarkBolek. Check them out. Dave and I go on a lot of the same rides, and it's just the same rides, a lot of it from a different perspective, you know, which is pretty interesting.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
We've done, you know, a couple poker runs together and different rides together with some of our buddies, and it's just a different viewpoint, but check them out.
Oh, yeah, I'll make sure to put a link in the description of your channel so everybody can click on that. And, if you like the video, subscribe. If you don't, don't watch it. That's what I do with my channel. You know, if you like my videos, love to have you. Go ahead and subscribe. If you don't like it, that little X is up in the upper right-hand corner.
That's right. You don't have to watch it.
That's right. That's right. Well, all right, TriMark MC, Mr. Bolek. I'll go ahead and cut this video off now, and I'm glad that you're doing better. I'm sure that all of my subscribers and everything have been really watching for you and watching your progress and everything and all this unfortunate incident that happened. So we'll go ahead and shut it off here. And like I said, man, I'm glad you're doing better, buddy. I am.
Yeah, I am too. And good talking to you again, Dave.
All right, bud. We'll catch you guys and gals later. This is the Smarter Cowboy here via telephone communication with TriMark MC, Mr. Mark Bolek. Wishing you and yours a good day. And until next time, adios.